Next, we turn to the growing criticism of anti-gay laws in Russia. They're generating protests around the world just as the Russians gear up to host next year's Winter Olympics. The refrains have been similar at demonstrations across Europe and the U.S. On Saturday in London, British comedian Stephen Fry didn't mince words in describing Russian President Vladimir Putin and his government's new laws.
It's just a very convenient way of uniting brutal people, neo-Nazi people, to be your brute squad. And that's what, I'm afraid, Putin is doing and has done.
Putin signed a measure in June banning public expression of homosexual identity and affection. Supporters said it's to protect the young.
It outlaws the spreading of information aimed at forming non-traditional sexual attitudes among children, attractiveness of non-traditional sexual relations, and a distorted perception of social equality between traditional and non-traditional sexual relations.
Gay rights activists argue it gives Putin's government free rein to suppress speech.
I think that the law is so vaguely formulated that you can use the law to criminalize every expression of being gay or lesbian. And I think that way you erase the homosexuality out of the minds and out of the street. You make it invisible.
Another measure prohibits the adoption of children by foreign couples who are gay or lesbian.
No more Russian vodkas.
Some opponents of the laws have taken to dumping Russian vodka to make their point. Others are urging a boycott of the Winter Olympics, set for February in the Russian city of Sochi, along the Black Sea. But so far, there's no sign that appeal is gaining much traction. President Obama said Friday a boycott hurts the wrong people.
I do not think it's appropriate to boycott the Olympics. We've got a bunch of Americans out there who are training hard. Who are doing everything they can to succeed.
In the meantime, the president of the International Olympic Committee says he's asked Russian officials to clarify how the law banning homosexual expression will be applied during the games.
The Olympic Charter is very clear. It says that sport is a human right and it should be available to all regardless of race, sex, or sexual orientation. And the games themselves should be open to all, free of discrimination. So our position is very clear.
The Russian ambassador to the UN answered Thursday, speaking to protesters outside his residence in New York.
All athletes, I can tell you, are going to be just fine. Going to be just fine. But we do expect everybody to respect our laws as well.
Russian police are already reinforcing that point, arresting protesters opposed to the laws. With me now is Miriam Lanskoy, Director for Russia and Eurasia at the National Endowment for Democracy. Tell me, how did this come to a head right now?
There are more than one thing going on. The law itself is part of a general crackdown. There's been several pieces of legislation, laws against NGOs, against public protests.
Non-governmental organizations.
Non-governmental NGOs. Organizations against different forms of public protests, new restrictions on the internet. It's come to a head because to remain in power and to remain the dominant party at all levels, Putin's government needs to clamp down and it needs to find internal enemies and try to change the subject away from things like transparency or elections or government accountability.
Is this a sentiment that runs deeper than the Moscow elites or the government? Is this something that is speaking to an underlying general feeling within the Russian population?
There's a polling that finds Russian society is very homophobic still. They find that most Russians still consider homosexuality to be a disease or a perversion. Trying to show it as a kind of a type of foreign influence. And what Putin has done is to try to use to try to create a narrative of what is truly Russian. and to use very primitive nationalist, homophobic, xenophobic attitudes.
Does the Russian Orthodox
critics.
Church play a role in
yes,
that?
Yes, the church plays a role in that. There was a very famous case of the Pussy Riot, a punk band that performed a song in a church that was against Putin, got 3 years in jail. Mm-hmm. Subsequent to that, there were laws to protect Russian values and the Russian church. So what is really a horrible campaign against gay activists and increasing in violence against gays is part of this larger picture.
Is the debate happening just within Russia? Obviously, we heard the President of the United States speak on it, but are there other people weighing in internationally on this?
There have been protests. Whenever Putin goes to Europe now, there are protests. There are protests in Belgium, in Netherlands, in Germany. So it's definitely gathering steam. We've seen that with other types of human rights movements. When there's a strong movement in Europe and the U.S., they start to express solidarity with other parts of the world.
But there used to be a law that outright banned gay sex that was repealed in, 1993.
It was Soviet law.
It was a Soviet law. So why aren't they making progress in some ways?
They were making progress it became possible, slightly more space was there. There were underground nightclubs that then became a little bit more open. But overall, the society, if you compare it to 5 years in prison for homosexuality, which was the Soviet standard, it's made progress. But still, a news anchor was fired for coming out publicly. What you also have, what's very important in Russia, is just heightened activism. And the a man who found that he couldn't report the news and keep talking about it as though it was happening to someone else. So he came out publicly, which is extremely, extremely rare. Mm-hmm. So there is a new generation that's out there that is trying to speak up more and kind of assert ability to come out.
How much would we be paying attention to this in the broader world if it weren't for the Olympics? And how much is the coming of the Olympics in February driving some of this international debate?
I think the Olympics is a obvious kind of rallying cry for people. I think we would be paying attention to it regardless, because there was a terrible killing in May where a man was tortured and killed. There are Russian groups that have become better at getting their message out, that use social networks and kind of get traction abroad. There's a more confident international gay rights movement. The Obama administration has made gay rights a priority, and that's something that is from 2011. They'd asked the State Department to start reporting on instances of abuses against LGBT. So there are a number of different things that are coming together, but the Olympics is a focal point for this.
And is this also a focal point? Is this an important central issue for Vladimir Putin himself, or is this something?
Of course, yeah. This is his prestige. It's extremely important, both in terms of being a leader on the global stage, financial terms, it's a point of pride for him. It's extremely important.
Miriam Lanskoy of the National Endowment for Democracy, thank you so much.
Thank you.